Difference keying is a great technique that can save your shot when nothing else seems to work. It lets you quickly isolate your subject or things like smoke, fire, and other tricky elements that classic keying or roto tools just won't cut it. Difference keying is a technique for generating an alpha channel by finding the difference between two images. Here's how it works. Can you see the difference between these two images? Well, it's pretty obvious here. That's the person. If you can see it, Silhouette can see it too. Let me bring in the difference mat node and connect both images to it. At first, it might look like nothing changed, but if I press A on the keyboard, we now have an alpha. The more the pixels differ in RGB values, the more opaque the alpha is. That's why we get a denser alpha for the t-shirt, while other areas, like legs, are closer in color to the greens behind, making the alpha less opaque there. Areas that look the same in both images show up black, meaning they'll be transparent when composited over a new background. You can adjust the gain of the mat, basically controlling how strong the effect is. Or offset the matte values either darker or lighter. If you just need a hard alpha, you can add an alpha threshold node and set its value to 1. You're not limited to comparing just static frames. The same principle works with motion. First, add a hold node and find a good frame where your subject is no longer in the shot. This will serve as a clean plate. Then connect both inputs to the difference mat node and crank up the gain until the alpha for the subject is mostly white. In most cases, I just set it to the maximum value of 10. If you start getting noise or artifacts like this over here, here's a quick way to clean your alpha. Add a matte repair node and adjust the black clip parameter until most of the unwanted stuff is gone. You can also shrink your alpha to a very small value like 1 or 2. Then add another matte repair node and grow the alpha back to the same value you shrunk it to. This way, your main subject's silhouette stays the same, but most of the alpha noise is removed. Difference keying is a great technique to use when classic keying or rotoscoping methods won't work. For example, if you have a green object shot on a green screen, you'd probably have a hard time pulling a clean key with something like Keylight. But with the difference keying, it's just a matter of a few clicks. I'll repeat the same steps as before. And crank up the gain. If you're getting small gaps or uneven areas in your alpha, those are easy to fix with a matte repair node. Just tweak the white clip parameter. Just like that. Then adjust the black clip if needed. You can also blur it a bit to bring back some of that softness. Great! Now let's try compositing it over a background. It looks great both on a checkerboard and in a full comp. You can use difference keying not only to remove backgrounds, but also to bring elements back. Here's what I mean. I have a clip of a large ice cube with the product frozen inside. However, there's a big, ugly crack in the center. We couldn't leave it like that, so the task was to remove it. I do have a clean plate prepared already. If you want to see how I made it, let us know in the comments and I'll do a full breakdown of the project. For now, we'll just focus on the difference key part. The problem is, I can't just slap a clean patch over the main clip, as it would look bad. The fire streaks would be missing in that area. So we need to find a way to bring those flames back, but I definitely don't want to rotoscope the fire. Difference keying is a perfect tool for that. Let me find a good frame from the source clip where the fire spikes aren't covering the crack area and add a hold node. Then, fit the source clip and the hold frame into the difference mat node. If I press A on the keyboard now, I'll see nothing. The screen is completely black, indicating that there is no alpha. But why? That's because we're comparing the same frame to itself, so there is no difference. But once I move to any other frame, we start getting an alpha, which we can use to composite the fire back over the patch. Just add another composite node, connect the background to the second input, and the output from the difference mat node to the first input, so it will work as a foreground. Nice! We've restored most of the fire, but we're running into a small problem. Those noticeable gaps in the flame spikes right where the crack was. Let's fix that. It's best to treat the color and the alpha separately. For the color component, you can either just blur it, or what I like to do is use so-called Blur-Unpremult technique. First, pre-multiply the alpha so we isolate only the fire. Then add a blur node and set the value to 0. Follow it by an unpremult node. Now, while looking through the unpremult, see what happens when I start adding some blur. The color spreads out. It stretches the edges, giving a smooth, filled-in color. Exactly what we need. Compare this to a regular blur node. Which one you like better? Now for the alpha, we need to fill the gaps while keeping the overall flame spike shape. To do this, I'll add two mat repair nodes, just like I did with the jumping man example. But since I'm not trying to remove noise, and only one to fill the gaps, we need to process it in reverse. In the first mat repair node, I'll grow the alpha to its maximum. Then in the second node, I'll shrink it back to the original shape and add some blur to soften it. Just like that. The final step is to comp it back together. Since I only want to restore the fire spikes in the patch area, I need to limit the alpha to that region. I'll add an alpha composite node and connect the fire alpha and the patch roto shape to it. Then set the blend mode to multiply. Now the alpha is limited to just that patch and I can use it as a matte input in the composite node. And that's how we bring the fire back using the difference keying technique. Difference keying won't give a perfect result on every shot, but it can solve problems no other keyers can. And like all keyers in Silhouette, you can mix and match them to get exactly the result you need.